वंदेहं श्री गुरु श्रीयुता पदकमलं
Yes, this is the perfectional stage of yoga system, yoga practice. A person is said to have attained to yoga. That means, yoga means connection. Just like the same example. Suppose this finger was out of my body. Or don't take this finger, take any machine part. It is out of the machine, lying idle. And as soon as you join with the machine, it works, it's different function. Katakat, 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 it works. With yoga, it has been joined. Similarly, we are now differentiated. These material activities, fruitive activities, they have been described simply wasting time. Murha. Murha. They have been described in the Bhagavad Gita as murha. Murha means rascal. Why? Such a big businessman, you say, rascal, why? He's earning thousands of dollars daily. But they have been described, murha, rascal, because they are working so hard, but what he's enjoying? He's enjoying the same amount of eating, sleeping, and mating. That's all. As a man who is earning millions of dollars daily, that does not mean he can enjoy mating millions of women. No. That is not possible. His power of mating is same one who is earning $10. His power of eating is the same with the man, one who is earning $10. So he does not think that my enjoyment of life is the same amount with the man who is earning $10. Then why I am working so hard for earning millions of dollars daily? Why am I spoiling my energy in that way? You see? They are called mudha, namang duskrita. Actually, he should have engaged. When he earns millions of dollars daily, he should have engaged himself, his time and energy, how to understand God, what is the purpose of life, because he has no economic problem. So he has got enough time. He can utilize in Krishna consciousness or God consciousness. But he does not take part in that way. Therefore he is mudha. Mura means, actually mura means ass. So his intelligence is not very nice. A person is said to have attained yoga when having renounced all material desires. If one is in perfection of yoga, then he is satisfied. He has no more any material desire. That is perfection. He neither acts for sense gratification nor engages in fruitive activities. Fruitive activities are also, fruitive activities means you earn something for sense gratification. One is practically engaged in sense gratification, and one is collecting money for sense gratification. So the fruity activities, suppose pious activities. Pious activities according to Veda, everywhere, if you are virtuous, if you give some money in charity, it is virtuous activities. If you give some money for opening hospital, if you give some money for opening schools, free education, these are certainly virtuous activities. But they are also meant for sense gratification. Suppose if I give in charity for distributing education, then in my next life I will be getting good facilities for education, I will be highly educated, or being educated I shall get nice post. But at the end, what is the idea? If I get a good post, if I get a good position, how do I utilize it for sense gratification? Nicely. That's all. Because I do not know anything else. And that is fruitive activities. If I go to heaven, a better standard of life, suppose in your America, a better standard of life than India. But what does this mean, better standard of life? The same, eating, sleeping, in a better type, that's all. You are not doing anything more. They are also eating. They are eating some coarse grain. You are eating very nice thing. But eating, not beyond this eating. So, my better standard of life does not mean any spiritual realization. A better standard of eating, sleeping, mating, that's all. So this is called fruitive activity. The fruitive activity is also another pattern of sense gratification. But it is on the basis of sense gratification. And yoga means connection with the Supreme. When the Supreme is connected, as soon as, just like Dhruva Maharaj, as soon as he saw God, Narayan, that boy was undergoing severe austerities, penances, to see God. He saw. But when he saw, then he said, Shamin kita thosmi barang na jase. My dear Lord, I am now fully satisfied. I don't want to ask anything, any benediction from you. Guess what is benediction? Benediction means you get very nice a kingdom, or a very nice wife, or very nice food stuff, very nice. These things we consider as benediction. But actually, when one becomes connected with God, he does not want any such benediction. He is satisfied, fully satisfied. Shamin kitathosmi barang na jache. The history of this Dhruva Maharaj, I have told him many times, that he was a child, 5 years boy, old. He was insulted by his stepmother. He was sitting on the lap of his father. He was trying. And his stepmother said, oh, you cannot sit on the lap of your father because you are not born in my womb. So he was a Kshatriya boy, although 5 years old, he took it a great insult. So he went to his own mother. Mother, stepmother has insulted him like this. He was crying. Then mother said, what can I do, my dear boy? Your father loves your stepmother more. What can I do? No, I want my father's kingdom. Tell me, how can I get it? Then mother says, my dear boy, Krishna, God blesses you, you can get. Where is God? She said, oh, we have heard God is in the forest. Great sages go there and find out. She went to the forest and underwent severe penances, and he saw God. But when he saw God, Narayan, he is no more anxious for the kingdom of his father. He is no more anxious. He said, my dear Lord, I am satisfied, fully satisfied. I do not want any more my kingdom, the kingdom of my father. He gave the comparison that I was searching out some pearls, but I have got valuable jewels. So that means he is more satisfied. When you actually connect yourself with God, then you feel yourself many millions times satisfied than enjoying this material world. That is God's realization. That is the perfection of yoga.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna.